Good evening, kids. So let us start this new topic today, matrix and determinant. Really easy, the easiest topic. You have done differentiation much easier than that. You'll find it much easier. So any arrangement, rectangular arrangement, basically you've done, I think, in computer science, arrays. So it is arrangement in rectangular form of numbers is known as matrices. So you are writing in terms of a rectangular form now. So if you see 1, minus 2, 3, 0, minus 5, 6, so in rectangular form or square form, you will see now. So first of all, these are known as matrix. A matrix is represented by a capital alphabet, capital A or B, C. The elements are represented small, A, small a, small a. And then once you write to group it, you will make the square brackets. Be very careful with the brackets. This is matrix symbol. You will see later this is determinant. So this we will not right now use. We'll just make determinant this matrix symbol. Now this horizontal lines are known as rows. So this is row 1. This is row 2. So this I can write row 1. This I can write row 2. This is vertical lines are known as column. This is column 1, column 2, column 3. The elements are indicated by small alphabets. If you see the number, first you will write row number. This is first row and this is first column. So first row, first column. First row, second column. First row, second column. First row, third column. So I can write A11 is 1. This is A12. First row, second column. First row, third column. This is second row, first column. Second row, second column. Second row, third column. So you'll write like this. So this is how we basically write a matrix. First you will write row, then you will write column. So A, I, J, M cross N. This is known as order of the matrix. Order is M cross N. Don't multiply, just write it like this. What does it mean? In this case, what is M? Number of rows. Number of rows 2. So this order is 2 cross 3. You can write 2 cross 3. A, I, J, M cross N. M is number of rows, N is number of columns. So 2 cross 3 is order of the matrix. So 2 cross 3 is your order of the matrix. This indicates the row numbers. This indicates column numbers. Now depending on how M and N are placed, we call it as rectangular matrix, square matrix. Rectangular matrix, M is not equal to N. If they are different. So this, what is the order now? This, how many rows? 1, 2, 3. 3 rows and how many columns? 2 columns. So the order of the matrix is 3 cross 2. If M and N are equal, then it is known as square matrix, 3 cross 3, 2 cross 2. In this, when you say order, we just write square matrix of order 3. That means 3 cross 3. Don't write 9, 9 is the number of elements. So order is 3, this order is 2. Now depending on that, we start getting various matrix. Now most of the cases, you will find square matrices coming. So for square matrix, we define something known as diagonal elements. If you see this diagonal element, sir, this is 1, 1. This element is A22. This element is A33. If I is equal to J, then those elements are known as diagonal elements. Don't get confused with diagonal of a square. This is also diagonal, but they are not diagonal elements. We only call principal diagonal elements. So only these elements are known as principal diagonal elements. A11 is 1, A22 is 0, A33 is this number. Similarly, this A11 is 1, A22 is 4. So these are known as principal diagonal elements. Depending on how diagonal elements are placed with respect to other elements, we call it as different type of matrices. First is diagonal matrix. Diagonal matrix is a square matrix. All elements other than principal diagonal elements are 0. See, all other elements are 0. Only these elements are there. So whenever I is not equal to J, Aij is 0, Aii will not be equal to 0. This is known as diagonal matrix. A diagonal matrix is defined only for square matrix. Then you have scalar matrix. Scalar matrix is a diagonal matrix. Diagonal matrix means it is a square matrix. In this, what is the difference between diagonal matrix and the scalar matrix? All the diagonal elements are same, constant number, same number. 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 4, 4. So basically all scalar are diagonal, but all diagonal need not be scalar. Then you have the most important matrices of matrix chapter is unit matrix or identity matrix. It is denoted by capital I. In this, it is square, it is diagonal. Then it is square, diagonal and scalar. only difference is scalar number is 1. So this is 1 1 1 1 1, so these elements are 1 only. Again, if all the identity matrix has to be scalar, but all scalar are not identity, so these are known as identity matrix. Then you have row matrix. If it contains only one row, then 1 2 3, this is one row, and any number of column known as row matrix. If only one column, it is known as column matrix. If all elements which are below the diagonals are zero, only those elements which are above the diagonals are there, these are known as upper triangular matrix. See, this below the diagonals, these elements are zero. Similarly, if all the elements above the diagonal are zero, this is known as lower triangular matrix. You also have in this something known as null matrix. Null matrix is denoted by capital O. So it is all elements are zero. If all elements are zero, we call it as null matrix. So this is very simple. This first exercise will be able to solve. So what you will do, just go through the video again, understand and start solving exercise 3.1. And please send me the solution by the end of this class. Please start solving exercise 3.1 of NCERT and start sending the solution. Thank you.